It's been almost a decade in the planning, the centrepiece of the Barangaroo development. But tonight, Crown's dreams of a Sydney casino are in tatters. The regulator banning gaming operations at the new $2.2 billion resort indefinitely.
It was always going to be the jewel in James Packer's crown, a lasting legacy in his hometown, a cash cow that now can't generate cash.
We're not comfortable with their gaming operations opening until we receive the report from Commissioner Bergen.
That's an inquiry that's put Crown under a blowtorch to decide whether it's even fit to hold a licence following damning allegations, a decision that would be devastating for its major shareholder and former executive chairman.
I think this has been a terribly painful and terribly shocking experience.
Crown had wanted to open one of its four gaming floors at Barangaroo and the rest of its shiny operations before Christmas. Now it will have to negotiate a limited opening of its hotel, restaurants and bars alone. The clincher for the Liquor and Gaming Authority, last minute evidence, 11 o'clock last night from Crown solicitors to the inquiry confirming money had been laundered through two of Crown's bank accounts.
This particular type of business is a bit of a magnet for money laundering, and we're greatly concerned about it.
The Commissioner's findings are due early next year. Crown says it now won't apply to commence gaming until February. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.